Hello and welcome. My name is Claire Nickerson. I am the Learning Initiatives and Open Educational Resources Librarian here at Fort Capaz State University. And my preferred pronouns are she, her, hers. And I'm here to talk to you today about organizing an OER boot camp for your faculty, which is something that we've done for the last 3 years running here at Fort Hays. So we have learned a lot, and I'd like to share it with you. So our learning outcomes for today: first, choose critical topics for getting faculty started on Z course projects. Those would be the topics that you teach at your boot camp. Implement interactive activities for faculty getting started on Z course projects. In other words, courses that use zero cost course materials. And avoid the issues and challenges faced by the FHSU OER Committee in implementing a boot camp. So a little bit about our boot camps. First of all, why did we decide to do boot camps? We have an ongoing mini conference series where we teach OER basics each year. So that was not the goal. In fact, our primary audience was faculty who had recently received one of our grants from the OER committee. We have two, well, we used to have a grant program called the Open Textbook Grant Program, which was implemented in 2016, and it required some original authoring. So the recipients had to either author, adapt, or add supplementary materials to an existing open textbook. Starting this year, we replaced that with a Z course grant program where the recipients convert their course to use zero cost course materials, regardless of their copyright status or any original authoring required. But we do have a preference for large enrollment courses for that. In terms of organization, the boot camps were organized by the OER committee, and the sessions were led by the OER librarian, which would be me. And staff and instructional designers from our Teaching Innovation and Learning Technology unit. We have for the past 3 years scheduled the boot camp for 2 half-days during the week after finals week of the spring semester, and schedules were slightly different each year based on the grant recipients' schedules. We did also invite as a secondary audience any other faculty or staff who wanted to attend. So our numbers have been gradually growing. We started out pretty small. So here is the schedule for the very first boot camp. We called it a beta version. We did it here in the library in 2019. We started with a session called Why Open, in which we gave each attendee time to read an excerpt from an article or book on open education concepts, and I will show you that reading list, and then to report back and discuss with the rest of the group. And we also did a persona exercise, which I'll share with you, in which faculty received a basic persona and then elaborated on how that persona would relate to course materials. We only scheduled that for half an hour, and the discussion was very lively, so we decided that we wanted to make it a little bit longer the following year. Second session was on project management. It was taught by one of our instructional designers, and she used excerpts of checklists and worksheets from the BC Campus Open Education Self-Publishing Guide. We had a session on textbook logistics, which used excerpts from the Open Education Network publishing curriculum on developing a textbook structure and textbook elements. And we actually brought in textbooks from the stacks and asked faculty to analyze the structure of those textbooks using a worksheet. Remember, at this point in time, everyone who attended was had received an open textbook grant, so they were working specifically on developing a textbook, and I will show you that worksheet that we used. For the accessibility section, we went over accessibility and universal design for learning concepts, and we provided accessibility checklists from BC Campus's adaptation guide and UDL rubrics from CAST, which was formerly the Center for Applied Special Technology. I do have links to these resources later on in the presentation. We gave attendees some lab time to familiarize themselves with Pressbooks. At that time, we had just subscribed to Pressbooks, which is an authoring software that we use for open textbooks. And then day two, we started with some Q&A and reflection time for attendees to discuss what they'd learned and what questions they still had. For copyright and licensing, we went over the basic concepts and then we played a game, which I'll share with you later in the presentation. And then we brought in the librarian who manages our scholars repository to talk about how attendees could share their work on their open textbooks. So we went over how to use metadata, how to submit to OER repositories that provide peer review, and how to get print copies for students. And here is our reading list for that first session, Why Open. We didn't have attendees read the entire articles. We just gave them short excerpts. So here is our year one persona exercise. You can see that each of these personas has a name and a student status and a brief profile. And then we asked attendees to use a worksheet to expand on their personas and fill them out a little bit in terms of their approach to finances and the stresses in their life and how they might relate to course materials. And we asked attendees to keep that in mind as they continued through the rest of the workshop. We did not do this persona exercise in year two, but we did bring it back in year three without the worksheet because we had limited time. Speaking of limited time, we also, after year one, cut this textbook examination exercise, particularly because after year one, not everyone's working on a textbook, an open textbook authoring project, but these are the questions that we asked attendees to answer as they were examining their print textbooks from our library stacks. So in year two, which was May 2020, we held the bootcamp via Zoom due to the pandemic. We do have recordings. I put the link up there. They were intended primarily for internal use, so we have not done any editing on those. They have all of the ums and uhs and, you know, dead air at the beginning. So if you do decide to watch them, just be aware of that. This was also the first year that we opened up attendance to folks who had not received one of our OER grants. And so it was also the first year that we had a formal sign-up, although we did still schedule the boot camp around the grant recipients' schedules so we could make sure that they attended. We started with the project management session. The content stayed mostly the same, but we changed the order in order to accommodate the presenter's schedule. For the Why Open session, we sent out the readings ahead of time per suggestion from year one. But we discovered that almost no one read them ahead of time, so we might in the future want to go back to giving attendees time to read excerpts so we can have a more lively discussion. Accessibility, the content stayed mostly the same, but we moved to a more formal traditional presentation style. We covered alt tags, image and video captioning, tables and graphs, best practices for linking, all of those good things. And we added a second persona exercise focused on redesign and accommodation from BC campus, which is linked later in the presentation. We also did a more traditional presentation on copyright and licensing using our copyright libguide. And we also have a lovely flowchart for best practices for obtaining copyrighted readings. We did keep the game, which I promise I will show to you. The primary difference from year one, aside from the fact that we conducted year two via Zoom, is that we tried to do some breakout sessions to accommodate attendees working on different types of projects, because we had some folks who were working on open textbook projects and some folks who were just interested in the content and were not working on open textbook projects. But unfortunately, neither of those breakout sessions worked out. We had to cancel the sharing and metadata one because the presenter got sick, and we actually ended up just breaking the second breakout sessions on Pressbooks and zero-cost course materials into two and just doing half and half because the attendees all wanted to attend both of those. And so we did not, in fact, do them at the same time. We took turns. We also added the free to use images breakout session to encourage our open textbook authors to use more visual content, because that was something that we noticed in our early open textbooks was that they didn't use as much visual content. We also reprised our lab time and the reflection and Q&A time. And so we formalized asking for ideas for improvement for next time. So in a moment, I will show you our attendees' feedback from that session. So here is the free to use images cheat sheet that we used for year two and also year three in that finding free to use images session. I particularly want to point out the last link in the photograph section, which is a lovely blog post that has a list of sites for finding diverse photos. It has, I think, women in tech and people of color and individuals with disabilities, among other things. So here's some of the feedback that we got on year two. Attendees liked having time to chat and share information, and they enjoyed having a variety of speakers and session types. They enjoyed having interactive exercises like the persona exercise in the accessibility section. And they enjoyed having a list of recommended reading, even though, as I said, most of them had not read it ahead of time. They wanted to hear more about other attendees' projects or interests and reasons for attending the session at the beginning. They also asked to start with a broader section or a broader session. In other words, not project management, although as I said previously, we did schedule it that way due to when the presenter was available. They asked for more examples of platforms and zero-cost course content that others were using. And they also asked to hear from faculty with experience conducting Z course projects, in other words, converting their courses to zero-cost course materials. Some of the things that attendees said that they learned that copyright status is a spectrum, not a binary. They learned how to be better advocates and talk with peers about the advantages of Z resources. That was something that came up in that Y Open discussion session after we abandoned trying to talk about the recommended readings and just chatted more generally. They learned about how using Z resources empowers students with additional access and flexibility. So there are reasons beyond cost savings to use zero cost course materials. They learned, of course, that students sometimes don't buy textbooks because they can't afford them, not because they don't find them valuable. So here is the schedule for year three, which is this year, 2021. Again, we did it via Zoom. Again, we have the link for the recordings there. One of the things that we did differently for year three was we brought in faculty from the OER committee, in addition to myself and our instructional designers. And we asked the faculty to run the discussion sessions and the reflection session at the end so that the presenters could leave and the faculty could provide some more anonymous feedback without the presenters listening to it. We also decided to incorporate some lab time into each session to give attendees some time to practice the skills that they learned in each session, rather than having a separate lab time, which really improved participation in the lab time. We started with attendee introductions, which replaced the Y Open discussion section. We still sent out the recommended readings and that persona exercise ahead of time, but we didn't discuss that. We did the attendee introductions instead per the feedback from year two, but we might bring back the discussion next year, because as I said, in year one, we had a very lively discussion. And I think if we give attendees reading time during the session, that perhaps we could reprise that lively discussion. We followed that up with press books. We decided to use press books basically across the bootcamp, even though some attendees might not be actually authoring books. And we created a sandbox book with a chapter for each attendee to play in. And so they practiced later on things like uploading images and adding alt text and embedding videos, those sorts of things that are, you know, useful across platforms, even if you are not using Pressbooks specifically. Accessibility session mostly stayed the same. We kept the persona exercise that was added in year two. Project management actually changed quite a bit. We moved to a panel discussion. Well, we had one of our instructional designers moderate that. And then as the coordinator for the grant programs, I was one of the panelists, and we brought in also a faculty member who had recently completed an open textbook project to talk about her project management process, since that was something that attendees in year two said that they wanted. On the second day, we spent some time on copyright and licensing. We did a presentation again with the game that I promise is coming. We combined searching for zero cost course materials and free to use images. So I used a Z resource search worksheet that is linked there if you would like to take a look at it. And we went over the free to use images cheat sheet that I already showed you. And then for the Q&A and reflection, the presenters were present during the Q&A session, but absent during the reflection. We had one of the faculty members who sits on the OER committee run that again, so that the attendees could provide that more anonymous, not completely anonymous, of course, since it was someone on the OER committee, but more anonymous feedback. So these are the resources that we used in the accessibility session. Just a disclaimer, I did not teach this one. One of our instructional designers did. So she has added more resources to this session every year, but this is the current version. And then here is the current version of the copyright game. Originally in year one, I did this as a card game. Loosely based on, I know that there is another copyright card game that exists, but then for online use via Zoom, I found this to be more convenient. The players got to choose one of the uses listed in the left column there, and then elaborate on the scenario, flesh it out basically into something that they might actually see themselves doing. And then as the facilitator, I chose a copyright status that was appropriate to the fleshed out scenario that the players chose and elaborated on. And then the players identified the relevant protected rights involved in the scenario, if there were any, and for some of them, there were not. And then talked about what exceptions might be relevant to that copyright scenario and how they would apply. So somewhat of a game, but also a tool to facilitate discussion around common scenarios that come up when you are considering copyright in relation to course materials. So here's some of the feedback that we got on year three. Attendees enjoyed getting to know Pressbooks. They were all very impressed by it, even though some of them, you know, are not working on open textbook projects and haven't used it really since then. They enjoyed having lab time to practice the new skills built into each section. And they apparently also enjoyed being called on to share their progress during lab time, particularly during the zero cost course materials search session with the worksheet. If you happen to watch the recording for that one, you'll see that we talked about each step of the search process, and then I paused the recording while the faculty went off to work on their searches, and then they came back and shared what they found. So that was satisfying. And they also shared that they felt really motivated to make changes to their courses after attending the bootcamp. The attendees really wanted to meet in person, particularly in relation to lab time and getting personalized feedback on their lab time. We will probably go back to being in person next year. Hopefully circumstances will allow that. They wanted to spend more time on copyright and licensing even though that was the longest session, they still felt like it was a little bit rushed. So we might actually break that up into two sections this coming year. They wanted to receive the recommended readings a little bit earlier. I don't know if they expected that they would have read them or just wanted to know what they were earlier. As I said, I'm thinking of bringing back the discussion session and giving them time in the discussion session to do some of the recommended reading. And they also suggested moving some of the content from the second day to the first day, because the second day, with the copyright and the licensing and the free to use images and finding zero cost course materials, ended up being a little bit more intensive than the first day, and they wanted to spread that out a little bit. The attendees learned, of course, how to use Pressbooks and about the resources that we have on campus to support this type of work, converting courses to use zero cost course materials. They learned how to locate and attribute images. And several of them said that there is a need for more Z resources in their disciplines, and again, felt motivated to work on that after conducting a search for zero cost course materials and not finding as much as they would have liked. So that being said, that is all 3 years in a nutshell and how we made changes between the years and why we made the changes that we did. I'm happy to share any of the resources that we used. If there are any resources that I didn't put on the slides that you would like, let me know. I'm happy to put links to them in the chat, or you're welcome to email me if you would like. But are there any questions?